Hello from San Francisco, California. We're live at Oracle Park. Today, the finale of this three-game weekend set. It's the Arizona Diamondbacks taking on the San Francisco Giants. John Ciambi, Chris Singleton with you. So the San Francisco Giants are in position to sweep this three-game series with a win. So, Chris, what's their mindset heading into today?
Yeah, looking to go 3-for-3, Boog. They've already won the series, and now they can really leave their mark. It's all about having confidence, and that's what a team takes away from a sweep. So they're happy to win the series, but they'll really be riding high tomorrow with the win today.
First pitch coming at you right after the break. Just about set to go. Our starter in this one, Alex Wood.
His career ERA's been under 4. What I like most about him is his reliability. Takes the ball every fifth day, ready to go whenever the manager calls.
So just about set now. Now the third baseman, Josh Rojas.
Leading off the afternoon for Arizona, the third baseman, Josh Rojas.
The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. That one misses. And that's how this game gets started.
First pitch, 12:05.
Next offering is in for a strike. So now 1-2.
Threw that fastball right by him, slightly elevated. That's a confidence boost for this guy out there on the mound. See if he continues to climb the ladder.
And now the lefty, swing and a miss, struck him out, one down.
That's that classic wipeout slider below the zone right there. Just nasty. Looks like a fastball thigh high that you got to protect the zone, and then it's just that late break that fools you and kind of makes you look silly.
Next to hit for Arizona, David Peralta. 2-for-8 in the series so far. First offering, and it just misses. No score, just getting started, top of the first. Next pitch is popped up. Flores settles underneath it, puts it away for the out.
Batting third.
Time to take a look at the Diamondbacks lineup. A guy who's been huge for them over the last month plus, Josh Rojas.
He's been a solid force for his team right now. Kind of a fire starter when you consider an on-base percentage over 400 over the last 10 games. That's solid, consistent work. He's making things happen for this offense right now.
Ketel Marte up to the plate. Marte carries the 8th best batting average in the National League entering play. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. Little slider action.
Out to center. Puts the squeeze on it, and that'll do it. And the Diamondbacks down in order. We'll go to the bottom of the first. 0-0. We go to the bottom of the first. Austin Slater stands in.
Leading up for the Giants, the center fielder, Austin Slater.
And the pitch. Swing and a high fly ball left field. Peralta under it. And out number one on the grab. Let's take a look at the lineup. Singy, the numbers tell us this is an offense designed to swing it. They're not going to force a ton of action on the bases, and so obviously that is one of the focal points that we'll look at.
And you look at the quality of the at-bats because of the fact that the legs aren't a part of this game. They have to be very selective, look for long pitch counts, grinding out at-bats, and really barrels to the baseball, because it's a lot easier to jog around the bases than for these guys to sprint.
That one ripped. And off the base of the wall.
Well, no waiting around right there. He was ready to swing it on the first pitch. Absolutely blasted that one into the gap, but just didn't have quite enough to clear the wall out there. Maybe a little more elevation under it, and it carries over, but that's a swing you'll be happy with every time.
One down, and now it's Wilmer Flores. And the first pitch misses for ball one. The next offering misses, and now 2-0.
Last two pitches have been down in the zone. Pitcher clearly trying to get that ground ball double play. But in this count, he's going to have to give in, elevate his pitches, and get back into this at bat.
Foul ball there. Crawford, the base runner at first with one out. Runner takes off. That one fouled off. 2-2. Mad bump deals. Swing and a high fly ball out there towards left field. And makes the grab. And there's two away.
Batting fourth, the left fielder, Josh Peterson.
Here's Jack Peterson. Fouled off to the right. Two outs. And strike two.
Not a swing you want to watch again.
Next offering misses. Now 1-2.
Pretty standard high 0-2 fastball right there. If you're smart, you'll look for something down in the zone, but not too far. Don't want to chase that breaking ball in the dirt.
And the next pitch is way outside. At the belt and fires. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. Here comes the runner. The throw is offline, and he's in to score. And it's 1-0.
Drove that ball nicely, put a great swing on it, and it jumped off his bat. Kind of put it all together there, and he's rewarded with the double.
Now it's Evan Longoria's turn.
Batting fifth, the third baseman, Longoria.
Now a screamer into the outfield. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And that's the inning. But a run will score in the inning on this RBI double. It's now 1-0. Top of the second. Now batting Jordan Luplow.
Leading off for the Diamondbacks, the right fielder, number 8, Jordan Luplow.
Wood back to work. That misses the zone, and that is ball one. It's a 1-1.
Outside, that's a ball.
It's Swing and a ball lifted in the air, left field, pretty well struck. High bounce, takes it over the fence. That's an automatic double.
He put a drive into that ball, and he was rewarded for it for sure. He probably wondered a little bit if he got enough of it to clear the fence in the air, but I'm sure he's plenty happy jogging into second with the automatic double.
And now the batter is Carson Kelly. First offering misses the mark.
After the loss yesterday afternoon where they really didn't ever get things going on offense, I think this is an important opportunity right here to pick up an early run.
The lefty, the 1-0. In the air, right field. Hauls it in, and there's one away.
Batting sixth, the first baseman, Christian.
And now it's Christian Walker. So RBI spot, but Chris, this is a guy that is not really swinging the bat all that well here.
In this situation, you have a real good opportunity to get swings and misses and record a strikeout. I think you attack him in this spot.
Runner at second here, one gone. The next pitch misses, and it's a ball and a strike.
Definitely a swing and miss slider down and in. He finished that really well. Just couldn't get him to offer at it.
And here it comes. And there's a foul ball. Stays alive. Next pitch misses. The count now 2-2. One out and a runner at second. Next offering is foul back.
Well, he's desperately looking for that swing and miss. He's going to have to just change speeds a little bit, try to move it around, create just a little bit of illusion at the end.
And a foul ball. He stays alive. Swings and misses. That's the second out.
Well, that was a tough slider right there. He couldn't get a piece of it just to try to keep the at-bat alive. And hitters will tell you that slider, when a guy's able to really tunnel the pitch where it looks like a fastball and then late has really good bite, so tough to lay off of because you've made the decision you don't want to get beat by a fastball, and then you swing and you miss. You go back to the dugout shaking your head.
Nick Ahmed in the box with two gone and takes a look at a called strike. Luplo stands at second with two gone. Kicks and deals. Stays alive. Next one misses, and the count is even, 2-2. Man on second, two down. Swing and a miss, and that is that. One left for Arizona, and it remains 1-0. Bottom of the second, and digging in for San Francisco, Darren Ruff.
Up for the Giants, the first baseman, Jared Ruff.
pitch. There's a strike.
Well, we call that keyhole. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
The pitch. That one lifted to left. Peralta drifts towards it. Makes the grab, one down.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
This is Joey Bart.
He's looking to hit the ball the other way in 99% of his at-bats. But if you make a mistake middle in, he can touch you up for a four-bagger.
In there for strike one. The other way, and now maybe extra bases. Around first, digging for two. To second, pulls him off the bag. And at second with one away, Mike Yastrzemski up here. Sat out last night's game, but back in there today.
Mike Yastrzemski.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. And he deals.
Nope.
Kenny Jansen doing home plate duties in this one.
Not a huge strike zone from Jansen, so he can't really be called a pitcher's umpire, but he does like the bottom part of the strike zone. We may see some pitchers steal a few strikes down there, especially the ones right below the knees. That's if their catcher can present it properly.
The 2-0 is in for a strike. What about an umpire's height? How much of a role does that play in your experience and what the strike zone is like?
Yeah, I think it pushes the strike zone up a little bit, which, you know, as a former hitter, you like that. You wanted the ball up. You didn't want to have to deal with stuff down in the zone consistently.
And a pitch. He swings and hits a fly ball, center field. Varsho makes the catch, and there's two away. As the game has moved along, we see more and more information supplied by teams about the umpires. I've been in clubhouses where they have pictures of all four guys, nicknames, hometowns, and as well hobbies listed, just so you can kind of small talk the umpire a little bit.
That's great.
Mauricio Dubon at the plate now. Looks at one down below the zone. The next offering misses. 2-0.
Well, no need to go right at this guy. First base is open. He can hurt you. So make him expand his zone. If he doesn't, give him a walk.
Swings through that. The pitch. That to right. And that is the third out of the inning. So the Giants leave one, but they're on top 1-0. On to the third inning. Now it's the rookie DH, Buddy Kennedy.
Leading off for Arizona, the designated hitter, number 15.
The wind of the pitch. Ball one low.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
The wind and the pitch. just missed.
He's been raking in recent games, and a big reason why, getting ahead in counts. He's been able to do that consistently, and you see the results.
That one's spoiled, and the count now 2-1. Kicks and fires. Swing and a ground ball out to short. And one away in the top of the third.
Batting up, the center fielder, number 12, Dalton Varsho.
And now it's Dalton Varsho. No hits in the shutout yesterday afternoon. And first offering is fouled off. Next offering is in for a strike. One down, base is empty. And a foul ball, he stays alive. And down on strikes, two away. Here's Josh Rojas.
Third baseman, Josh Rojas.
And first offering is fouled off. Left-hand batter waits. And that one wrapped foul. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And that is that. Diamondbacks down quickly. They still trail 1-0. Back here at Oracle Park, set for the bottom of the third. Now it's the Giants' leadoff hitter, Austin Slater.
The center fielder.
Well, they've kept him pretty quiet in this series. Still doesn't have a knock. I know you want to get that first knock out of the way. Maybe more will come, but you got to give some credit to the pitching staff. They've had a great plan against him.
Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now. Next offering upstairs. Here comes a pitch. The punch out there, and there's one down.
Well, he didn't get the call on the mound the pitch before. Felt like he should have had him looking, I think.
No batter,
but, you know, that's good composure right there. He found a way to come back with another good pitch to get him to swing and miss.
Brandon Crawford, the next Giant to hit. Singled and scored his first time. And the first pitch misses for ball one. And now the lefty. And now 2-0. That one pulled foul. The pitch. Popped up. Rojas racing over to make the catch.
Now batting, the second baseman, Wilmer Flores.
And now Wilmer Flores. Chris, baseball today, so many strikeouts, and they are available to pitchers. But this is a guy that puts the bat on the ball and is kind of different from the players that we see day in, day out. Popped up right side. Marte makes the catch, and that'll do it. Giants are down 1-2-3, but they lead it 1-0. back here at the ballpark. On to the fourth, and here is David Peralta.
The left fielder.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
Swing and a miss, and it's 0-1. The next pitch misses, and 1-1. When you look at the elite teams in the game right now, there is going to be the slug, no question about it. But the really good offensive teams combine slug with more contact, with less swing and miss. Next pitch misses inside, and that's ball two. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. Leadoff hitter retired in the fourth.
Oh, nothing too fancy on the strikeout pitch right there. Just a low 90s fastball, and I'm not sure he was trying to challenge him, but that's pretty much what happened. Very hittable location, but he found a way to just get it by him.
And now it's the switch hitting second baseman, Ketel Marte. Carries the eighth best batting average in the National League entering play. And no one can get there. It falls in. Around first and hustling for second. And the tying runs at second base with a double.
Went up there looking to be aggressive and got something he could handle. Off the bat, it was headed for the gap all the way. And as a hitter, you love seeing those as you take your first couple of steps out of the box. You know you've got some real estate to run on. It's such a good feeling. Nice liner into the gap right there.
Now up next for Arizona, Jordan Luplo doubled his first time up. That one's in there, 0-1. Next pitch misses, ball one. Marte leads off second with one gone in the inning. The 1-2. In the dirt. And the 2-2. In the air, left field. Peterson on the move as he glides back. Two down.
Up next to the Diamondbacks, the catcher.
And here is Carson Kelly.
And Boog, I'd say he's due. No base hits in the series for him so far, and it's clearly been a rough one. You just hope he's not pressing too hard, because that just compounds things. It makes the slump even longer. Never seems to help. Never helped me.
There's a swing and a drive. That's back. Didn't quite have enough. One left for the Diamondbacks. Still behind by a count of 1-0. Here at San Francisco, bottom four, here's the left fielder,
leading
Jock Peterson.
For the Giants, the left fielder, Jock Peterson.
Mad Bum back to work. And that one just misses, a ball and no strikes. The pitch. There's a strike.
He's been pitching well, but going through this middle of the order second time through, we'll see what kind of adjustments are being made.
In the air, fairly deep to right field. Flashes the leather on the running catch. One away.
Now maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
And up next for the Giants, Evan Longoria. First pitch, and he just misses. Next offering is down low. Next one misses, and that's ball three.
A rare three-ball count here. He's been throwing strikes all day. Got to be ready to hit if you're in the box.
The wind of the pitch. And a four-pitch walk.
Four pitches. That's an easy walk, man. He could have walked me right there, Boo. The last one wasn't even close.
The first base.
One gone, runner at first. Darren Ruff, the next Giant to hit. And that's in there for strike one.
Generally, second, third time through the lineup, you want to be able to lean on those secondary pitches and command them. Looks like he's doing a nice job of it.
0-2 as he waves at that one. And the pitch. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him.
Thought it was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Catcher. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
Joey Bart, the next to hit. First pitch just misses. At the belt and fires. Just missed.
Looks like he's being a little cautious with him in this at bat after doubling the first time up. Doesn't want to make another mistake.
The 2-0 is in for a strike. Nice. 2-1 pitch is in there, and the count is even. Two outs. That's a laser base hit. Throw in holds the lead runner at second. Two on now with two away. That ball was absolutely ripped. 111 off the bat. And I'm pretty sure it started to whistle after it left the bat.
I think I heard that too, Boog. And these are the moments we appreciate when we can look at StatCast and just see exactly what the data is. Always so much fun to see what numbers pop up.
And now it's going to be Mike Yastrzemski. And that one fouled off. Longoria on second. Bart at first. Two out of the inning. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it. Got him looking. And that is that. On to the top of the fifth we go. It's the Giants 1 and the Diamondbacks nothing. Welcome back. Now it's going to be Christian Walker.
Leading off for Arizona, the first baseman, Christian Walker.
And here it comes. That one is upstairs.
All one, no strike.
Line drive. That's a base hit out of the left center field.
The batter, number 13, shortstop, Nick.
No outs,
Ahmed.
Runner at first. Nick Ahmed here to hit. in there for strike one. Nobody out, runner at first.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, try to stay out of a double play here.
That one out to right, Yastrzemski on the move. No trouble here, puts it away for the out. And there's one down.
Now that number 15.
So next is the designated hitter for the D-backs, Buddy Kennedy. First offering misses the mark.
You don't want to get beat by a fastball in, and he spits on that one.
Next offering is in for a strike. The pitch. Gonna count one and two.
Count one and two.
Wood checks on first. Walker back in on a dive. The pitch. That one missing inside. And now the count filled up 3-2. And a foul ball.
Well, you can't really adjust your game plan for that last pitch. Guy hasn't thrown it very much. You got to focus on the stuff that he's throwing up there most of the time.
Kicks and deals. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Stays alive. And it's ball four. He missed down low.
Well, a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches, and somehow Boogie found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
Two on, one out. Here's the center fielder, Dalton Varsho. Lifted in the air out to left. Peterson makes the grab, and there's two down.
Yeah, that was a wasted RBI opportunity, but competitor like him, he is looking forward to making up for it in his next at bat.
Josh Rojas stands in now for the Diamondbacks.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. And what you tell yourself is, I want to stay square to the plate, try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
In there, and it's 0-1. Two on, two outs. And that's outside. And a pitch. And a count 1-2.
The fastball at the bottom of the zone can be very effective. Just got to keep it on the corners.
First and second, two down. This one in the dirt. So the tying run at second. And he hits a ground ball right side. Flores on to first. That ends the frame. Home half of the fifth coming up. It's the Giants 1 and the Diamondbacks nothing. And welcome back. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Now it's the DH, Mauricio Dubon.
The designated hitter, Mauricio.
The pitch.
Dubon.
And a good eye there.
Count 1-0.
Oh. Center field, Varsho has a bead on it, and he makes the catch. And a quick out number one.
Now batting, the center fielder, Austin Slater.
So the batting order turns over, and now Austin Slater.
Well, on the mound, very efficient, able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at-bat.
Peralta gliding to his right, brings it in, two down.
Good pitch. He just kind of had him out in front on that pitch away and wasn't able to stay close.
Shortstop.
And up next for San Francisco, Brandon Crawford. Singled back in the first and scored their only run. He's one for two. On the ground to third. Reaches on the backhand, but it's through.
Well, clearly he was ready to hit right there. Just found a way to slap that ball down the third baseline. That's really excellent back control. And it kind of goes back to all those drills you see hitters do off the tee where it's placed in different spots. That was just nice.
So two down and digging in for San Francisco, Wilmer Flores. 2-for-7 in the series so far. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Lined, and that's a base hit.
Back-to-back base hits. Maybe a little out front of the pitch now right there, but he squared it up pretty good, and he kept it inside the line. Just a really nice job on the other side by the defense to hold that to a long single.
So two on, but two away. And Jack Peterson stands in. First offering, and it just misses. Kicks and fires. And a ground ball to first, and it's through for a hit. Crawford coming home. He scores, and they lead by two.
Even though he was really late on it, he clearly barreled the ball because that one was ripped down the line. He had to be really short with that swing, not get beat by that pitch.
So digging in, Evan Longoria.
Now batting, the third baseman, Evan.
That one's in there, 0-1. Late swing, fouled off. Next pitch inside, and a count 1-2. And a swing and a miss, and that's that. But they pick up one run on the RBI single, and it's 2-0. Go! Hey! Go! Hey! Go! Game on, we got no pity. A game on, yeah, we're coming for you. All your kids out. All right, we go to the top half of inning number six. David Peralta at the plate.
David Peralta.
Wood back to work. And a strike.
So important for him to control the heart rate right now. He's got to go through the heart of this lineup.
0-1 down. That catches the zone for a strike. 0-2 now.
It really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. One up, one down.
Second baseman, Ketel.
Here's the second baseman, Ketel Marte. Just 2-for-11 in the series so far. Singy, he's a guy that covers both sides of the plate about as well as anyone in the sport. How difficult is that to do?
Well, just look at the back of my bubblegum card. You'll see how hard it is. These guys are great, man. They have the ability to look out there, but also to be able to turn on the inside pitch. Those that can really sharpen things on the outer half, those are the ones that become elite.
Luplo.
Two outs, base is empty. And now the right fielder, Jordan Luplo. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Now, this manager knows that his players are just trying to do too much. Everybody needs to just take a deep breath, relax, and let it naturally happen.
Two down, nobody on. And that one fouled off. And a pitch. That one misses, and the count is 1-2.
One ball, two strikes.
Next offering is way upstairs. And a foul ball. He stays alive.
Well, he's having a tough time getting a pitch by him. As a hitter, you feel pretty confident that you're seeing different pitches still able to make some type of contact.
Next one is off the plate. 3-2 now.
Wow, this guy's really battling up there as if his run is the game-winning run. I love his tenacity.
And there's ball four.
Well, he earned his trip to first right there. It's not easy laying off pitches that just missed the zone like that. And it's a real discipline as well. He's put a lot of work into that aspect of his game, and it paid off right there.
Kelly stands in here, leaves that one off the inside. And he deals. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball. Luplo off of first with two away. Next offering misses, and it's 2-1.
We got two balls, one strike.
Next pitch is downstairs.
Well, these guys have had a hard time scoring in this one. The guy out there on the mound wants to keep attacking, make sure that they don't get any confidence.
This to center field. Slater under it. He's got it, and that'll end the inning. 6-7-8-2 in the bottom of the sixth. It's the Giants 2 and the Diamondbacks nothing. Back here at the ballpark, bottom of the sixth. And digging in for San Francisco, Darren Ruff.
The first baseman, Darren Ruff.
The wind of the pitch. And a foul ball. The next pitch misses. One ball, one strike.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Next pitch misses. 2-1. That's towards center. And there's one away.
Up next for the Giants, the catcher, Joey Bart.
Now it's the Giants catcher, Joey Bart. And that's in there for strike one. Activity in the bullpen. Chris Davinsky getting loose out there. Ramirez getting cranked up as well. The 0-1. Now 1-1. The 1-2. And a ball evens the count. Three-two now. Cut on and miss. Struck him out. So he's gotten deep into this game, and at least so far, not showing a ton of signs of fatigue. And up next for the Giants, Mike Yastrzemski. That one pushed to the left and foul. Next offering is in for a strike. Stays alive. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Pitch misses outside. 1-2 to count. Left-hand hitter waits. Out to short. Ahmed gloves it. Sends it across to first. Giants go in order. Nothing doing there for San Francisco. They're up 2-0. Top of inning number 7. And now the first baseman, Christian Walker.
Leading off for Arizona, the first baseman, Christian Walker.
The wide to kick the pitch. Just missed. Signs of movement in the Giants bullpen. Lucas Sims, a right-hander with big strikeout stuff, is getting it fired up. Doval warming up as well. The pitch. Broken bat, roller to first. Ruff takes it to the bag, and they get the leadoff hitter in the 7th.
The bat, number 13, shortstop, Nick Ahmed.
Next up for the Diamondbacks, Nick Ahmed. And first offering is fouled off. Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
Line drive, and there's a hit.
Good job of just putting the ball in play with two strikes.
Kind of a risky number pitch 15. Coming inside with the breaking ball like that. You have to bury it. Otherwise, it's not too difficult to get the bat to it like he did that time.
Here comes the manager out of the dugout, and he'll make a move for the bullpen. Alex Wood done for the afternoon. Two-run ball game as he heads for the dugout, and we'll be back with a new pitcher. Jose Alvarez taking over on the mound, and he'll do his best to hang on to this lead.
Jose Alvarez.
Buddy Kennedy stands in now for the Diamondbacks. First pitch just misses.
Now these guys definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
And now the lefty. And that's down and away. Throw over to first, and he's back in safely. Ahmed, the runner at first, with one gone in the inning. Next offering is downstairs. So definitely a little wild right out of the gate.
Well, it could be a little tough coming from the bullpen mound to this mound, but you've got to find a way to get ahead in the count quickly. He hasn't. We'll see how this at bat turns out.
That just missed. He walked him on four pitches.
Well, this could be the start of something. They haven't found a way to score yet, but now's their chance to change that.
First and second, one out. Dalton Varsho now at the plate.
Well, that's really the money spot. Down and away, if you can locate that consistently, it's going to be real tough for guys to square that up. That's what you'd love to see relievers do coming out of that bullpen.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Quickly into an 0-2 count. Both pitches were down in the zone. I think you set your sights a little bit higher, because you'll have a tendency to chase if you look down in that area.
And 1-2. Here comes a pitch. And another ball. And a pitch. And there's a ball.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
Two on, one out. Got him looking. Two gone.
So far, just one of those days for this lineup. You get a couple of runners on, and you're looking at having a big inning, and that strikeout right there just pours water on the fire. You look for the next hitter to step up and try to do something, pick up his teammate and his club.
Here's the Diamondbacks leadoff hitter, Josh Rojas. First pitch doesn't find the zone. And here it comes. And it's fouled away.
I want to start that load a little bit sooner because of the good velo.
Strike two.
Good late sink on that fastball. Out of the hand, looks so good. And then by the time it gets in the hitting zone, hard to get the barrel to it.
And now 2-2. Two outs. Couple of base runners at first and second. Now this is blasted way back there, on its way, gone. He powers one out to right field. Just like that, they move in front. It's 3-2.
Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
Zach Littell gets the ball now, and his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance. Next to hit for Arizona, David Peralta.
Now back the left fielder, David.
In there, and it's 0-1. Right-handed reliever, and it's 1-1.
Nasty backdoor slider. There's really nothing you can do with that if you swing at it, so that's a good take by him.
So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Next pitch way upstairs. And that one moves his feet.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Payoff pitch. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. But the big blow of the inning comes right here, a three-run homer. It's now a 3-2 ball game. Bottom of the seventh, and now the DH, Mauricio Dubon.
Leading up for the Giants, the designated hitter, Mauricio Dubon.
The pitch. Misses outside, 1-0. Flares it into the outfield, and it's caught for the out.
Now batting the center fielder, Austin.
Back to the leadoff spot of the Giants lineup. And now the center fielder, Austin Slater. First offering misses the mark. Next pitch is downstairs. And a foul ball makes the count 2-1. Fouled off. He was late. The pitch. On the ground, right side, and there's a hit.
Well, that was one of those high percentage advantage counts where batting averages are just so much higher. Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team to bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep. Now a huge at bat in this game coming up.
Here comes the skipper, and we're going to see a pitching change in this spot. Madison Bumgarner will depart, and as he heads off, we'll step aside for a minute. Back with the new pitcher after this break. So out of the pen for the Diamondbacks, Joe Mantiply. He last pitched 2 days ago.
Joe Mantiply.
One down, runner at first. Brandon Crawford getting ready to hit. That one's in there, 0-1.
If you're a base runner, you got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
Next pitch is outside, and that's ball one. Next one misses, 2-1. Slater over at first with one away. On the ground a second, might be two. There's one. And that's quick work out of the pen. One batter, two outs, inning over.
Well, the second baseman made that one look easy. Great feed to the shortstop. Shortstop completes the play. They get out of a jam and they end the inning.
Back here in San Francisco, here's Ketel Marte.
Well, he's been having a great year this year. And hitting home runs at a good clip, and the matchup is very favorable.
First offering, and it just misses. Bullpen activity starting up now. Johnny Brebbia up and throwing. McGee getting loose as well. The 1-0. And that one just missed off the outside edge.
2-0 count to a guy with this much pop at the dish. Better expect him to be turning on something. It's going to either get hit hard to the pull side or the fans better look out in the stands.
Now 3-0. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Well, that could be a tone setter for the inning. Four straight pitches and leadoff batters on base. We'll see if the next guy waits until there's a called strike before he takes the bat off the shoulder.
Luplo in the box now. No balls and a strike. Next offering is in for a strike.
Don't play situation here. He's been working up in the zone. Typically, you look for guys to get that ground ball. See if he adjusts on this next pitch.
And the righty deals.
Well, with the amount of pitches that can end up in the dirt, a good secondary lead doesn't have to get away from the catcher, but if you're anticipating based off the trajectory, get yourself in the scoring position.
Chases that one out of the zone, and that's the first out. Here's the catcher, Carson Kelly. First pitch, not close. And the 1-0. He swings and fouls one off. One run game, one out, one on. And a count 1-2. ground ball to the right side. Into the outfield, base hit. Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds at second with one gone.
Well, the last 10 games or so have been anything but fun at the plate for him, so that one has to feel good. Not a bad slider by any means. It was down and away, but an even better job to spoil that thing. And he let it travel, didn't try to hook it. Man, that's a really good approach.
And now, Christian Walker. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Next offering upstairs.
Looking for some insurance, or as our friends down in the South would say,
insurance.
No matter how you say it, we know what you mean.
Runner. Double steal. Next offering is fouled back. Righty delivers, and down on strikes he goes, and there are two down.
Well, this guy's been pretty much a non-factor so far this weekend. Very little in the way of impactful at-bats and quality at-bats, and let alone contact. That's the sixth time they've set him down on strikes in the series, so no doubt frustration mounting and very high right now.
So first and second with two outs. Now up next for Arizona, Nick Ahmed. And he's already singled in this game. The 1-0. And fouled off. Next offering is in for a strike.
One ball, two strikes.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. Right-hander kicks, deals. Got him swinging. That's out number three. Diamondbacks strand a pair, but they're up 3-2. Now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Keone Kela. The offense will need to be ready for the breaking stuff. He's got a great curveball. Back here at Oracle Park, bottom of the eighth. Now it's the second baseman, Wilmer Flores. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power. And the pitch. Good eye right there. At the belt and fires. On the ground, right side. Marte throws the first in time. And that is a big first out.
The left hander, number 23, Jack Peterson.
And now Jack Peterson.
Well, he came up clutch earlier in this ball game and really just needs to take the same approach. Think hard right back up the middle.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. next offering is down low.
Now you get to this part of the order, yeah, there's some pop there, but more likely there's some base hits. So very important to be patient. Let the pitcher walk you, if he will. I almost feel like he's frustrated a little bit. He wants to be challenged.
Righty to the plate. Swing and a miss as he was out front that time.
Well, pretty clear to me. He was trying to go deep right there, but you got to get a pitch that you can handle.
The tying run at the plate. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. And that quickly, two away.
Well, we saw a solid effort out of their starter, and the bullpen is now following suit. It's just a good day as a manager or as a pitching coach when you can hand the ball off to multiple arms and get stability from all of their performances.
Evan Longoria, the next Giant to hit. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Kicks and deals. So two balls and no strikes. Swing and a miss. And that's strike one.
Well, he came right at him right there, challenged him with the 2-0 fastball. Not sure exactly what he was looking for, but got to imagine that's a confidence booster on the mound. You're in that hitter's head a little bit.
Looking to get the tying run on base. That misses the zone, and it's 3-2. And that one in the air center field. Barsho moving under this one. And that will end the inning. Giants down in order, and it's still a 3-2 ball game. So here comes Jake McGee into the game.
Now pitching for the Giants, number 17, Jake.
All set to start the ninth in this one. Now at the plate, Buddy Kennedy.
Heading off for the Diamondbacks, the designated hitter, number 15.
The pitch. Now that's smacked to right center. Slater makes the grab. One pitch and one out.
The center fielder, number 12, Dalton Varsho.
Here's the center fielder, Dalton Varsho. Up the middle. Throws to first. Two quick outs here in the top of the ninth. Running out of chances to pad the lead.
Now batter, the third baseman, Josh Rojas.
Here's the third baseman, Josh Rojas. Probably feeling pretty good about himself based on that big swing of the bat in the seventh.
Well, he should be feeling good. I mean, a three-run shot, beautiful swing. And, of course, it's made a big impact on the score in this one. So you always love it when you do something special like that and it impacts the ballgame.
And that's in there for strike one.
Not looking like they'll be adding any insurance runs heading to the bottom of the ninth. So it's going to be on the bullpen to hold this lead.
0-2 as he waves at that one.
This guy's not wasting any pitches. Hitters got to get into swing mode. This is a good time to expand the zone. Throw something maybe down in the dirt.
Next pitch misses way outside. And now it's 1-2. Got him. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3, 6-7-8 schedule to start the bottom of the ninth. It's the Diamondbacks 3 and the Giants 2. Here comes Mark Melancon.
Now pitching for Arizona, number 34, Mark Melancon.
Bottom nine, and digging in for San Francisco, Darren Ruff.
Leading up for the Giants, the first baseman.
These home fans, they are making a lot of noise, putting pressure on that pitcher out there.
First pitch just misses. This one popped up. Ahmed in position. Hauls it in for the out.
Up next for the Giants, the catcher, Joey.
Joey Bart, the next Giant to hit. First pitch, and he just misses.
Home plate umpires trying to tighten things up a little bit.
Crowd locked in right now. One run game here in the ninth. Now a rip into left center. Peralta puts it away, two away.
Man, that's so frustrating. You hit the ball hard. You understand the situation. You want to get on base and try to score that tying run, but no reward right there, and just going to have to sit on it.
Mike Yastrzemski, the next Giant to hit. Foul ball.
Just missed. If he's able to connect on that, look out.
A one-run lead here in the last half of inning number nine. That one hit to right. Luplo under this one. He's got it. Ball game. And the Diamondbacks hold on to win a tight one as this one ends as a one-run ball game.
Well, Boog, four games wasn't too long of a losing streak, but they're definitely happy to be back in the win column. Now you can turn things around, get on the right track, and probably start a winning streak from here.
Final line score for our ball game this afternoon for the victorious Diamondbacks: 3 runs, 6 hits, no errors. They left 7 men on base. For the Giants, 2 runs on 8 hits, no errors. They left 7 men on base. Time of the ball game: 2 hours and 53 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon, and we remind you to please.